concrete is the second most used material in the world after water, and the concrete is actually the number one used material in the world if we speak about man-made materials. My name is Branko. I'm associate professor in civil and environmental engineering, and my area of the research is in structural health monitoring. Structural health monitoring means installing the sensors of the structure and trying to understand if there are any strange behaviors, which we like to call unusual behaviors, and if yes, if those unusual behaviors are within the limits of normal or there is some issue with the structure that has to be fixed.
So what we are doing is to installing deformation sensors in the structure. On that particular day, my job was to install the sensors. So we attached the sensors to the reinforcement of a column, for example, and then to be there during the pouring process so that we can guarantee the integrity of the sensors, make sure that it's still working while it's being poured. It's also interesting to capture the very first curing of concrete, so you can capture, for example, the heating of concrete. And it's also important to capture data of things that you don't have in mind right now, because they might become interesting in the future.
So this is East Parking Garage of Princeton University, the new structure. And we are at the site, you know, they are completing the construction slowly, and we are measuring the deformations of the foundation. What is unique with this project is that we have sensors in horizontal elements, which are slabs. We have sensors in vertical elements, which are columns. And we also have sensors in the foundation. So it is expected to work. And we see that the garage is, you know, working well. But however, what we don't know and we don't have experience is what is the behavior in long terms, you know, when we go over 5, 10, 20 years. And this is where the sensor can help us understand the behavior and then improve as we go.
In terms of the engineering aspect, I was able to see how the production process is organized, how they're able to manufacture so many of these pieces in such an efficient way. It was also interesting to understand where should you put your sensors and what the challenge involved on how you put the sensors. So when you're designing, for example, your structural health monitoring strategy, you have to think, okay, I want to put my sensor here, but how am I actually going to reach this place when this is being manufactured? So that has to be something that's thought about before. On a professional level, I was not also very knowledgeable about how is the interaction between, let's say, an academic partner and a private partner. Usually, these structures are not monitored, so this is kind of a special project, and that breaks their manufacturing process line. So you have also to design this. When should I be there? When would be the least impactful time for me to install my sensors to make sure that they're working? Another thing that's very interesting, and I think we could do a better job there, is to engage the workers in the community in what we were doing. They're usually very curious about what you're doing because it's something different for them. So there are all these aspects that are more social and not so technical, but I thought they were very relevant. That is very difficult to get when you're just sitting at with a computer or being inside the lab.